Thank you very much, Carol. This session is intended just as an opening session for the very esteemed speakers who will be taking part in the three main sessions, particularly our national and international guests. And we thank you very sincerely for making the great effort to come here. And also, we thank each of you for attending and hopefully participating actively in this conference. Our Minister for Justice has introduced two new so-called important laws recently. The first one makes blasphemy a crime. Why in the name of sweet suffering divine Jesus do we need a law on blasphemy? The second one was introduced there last Monday. It makes the possession of kamikaze swords unlawful in this country. Well, here I have not quite a kamikaze sword. It's actually an old Lee Enfield bayonet from World War I. It seems actually to have quite a lot of use as well. Now, technically speaking, maybe I could even be arrested for what I'm doing here now. I've been arrested 5 times at the Shannon Airport for doing a lot less. But very clearly, the laws that have been used in this country, like blasphemy laws and laws about samurai swords, are a bit of a joke. However, when we look at the fact that here at Shannon Airport, right across the car park from where we are speaking, right now we have a Hercules warplane on the runway and 200 or more troops in the terminal building. Clearly, we must ask what our priorities are. Over 1 million troops have passed through this airport since 2001, possibly as many as 1.5 million. And they have been involved in wars in Iraq, Afghanistan, and now in Pakistan that have led to the deaths of somewhere in the region of 1 billion people. Ireland has been dragged into this. We are complicit to a very significant degree. We are also witnessing munitions in large quantities being transported through this airport. We know that Morier have admitted that they have a license to transport depleted uranium through Shannon Airport. Now, why is all this important? Well, among other things, depleted uranium munitions in Bosnia, Kosovo, Basra, Baghdad and Afghanistan have caused serious cancers to hundreds and probably thousands of children who are dying horrible deaths due to the use of and the indiscriminate use of depleted uranium. The Irish government claims to respect international law, yet in this daily breach of the Hague Convention on Neutrality here at Shannon Airport, the Irish government not only allows US troops to transit through this airport, it actually invited them to do so back in late September 2001 and then gave them a blank check as to who and what they might bring through the airport. But that's all right according to your ministers. Sure, haven't we got secure promises in the long term? Well, maybe. That Ireland will get legally binding guarantees that the Lisbon Treaty will not affect, and in inverted commas, Ireland's traditional policy of military neutrality. Of course it won't, since there is no Irish neutrality, military or otherwise, since 20th of March 2003. However, our government fraudulently maintains that Ireland is still a neutral state on a regular basis. A recent report in the New York Times revealed that the Blackwater Mercenary Company is contracted to transport and assemble Predator drones, unmanned aircraft, for the specific purpose of assassinating Taliban leaders. This, of course, is highly illegal under international law and almost every other law. We are investigating at the moment whether any of these drones have been transported to Shannon Airport, as was reported in the Phoenix magazine last week. Some of these aircraft have been involved in the bombing of civilians in Afghanistan, including weddings that have killed dozens of women and children. Of course, in all such incidents, all the men killed are always listed as terrorists by the US military, and the civilians are just collateral damage. In case you think the Afghan war is some sort of peacekeeping operation, the latest reports from yesterday make it clear that this is a bloody war that will cause thousands of more deaths before the US and NATO will slowly learn or relearn the lessons of Algeria, Vietnam, Iraq, and the Russian lessons of Afghanistan in the 1980s. Yesterday morning, German NATO troops in northern Afghanistan, in the province of Kunduz, a force that includes 7 Irish soldiers, called in an airstrike that was probably provided by German Air Force jets on 2 stolen fuel trucks from which local villagers were drawing fuel. The fuel trucks had been stolen or liberated from a NATO convoy and were intended to fuel the war against the Taliban. Between the bombs and the burning fuel, up to 90 people, probably more at this point, were killed, and an unknown number seriously injured and burned. NATO claims all the victims were terrorists. These German NATO troops did not pass the Shannon airport, but it's most likely that more than half, well more than half, of the foreign troops in Afghanistan and Iraq have passed through Shannon airport. At least 500 troops a day are passing through at the moment, all of them armed. I am one of a team here at Shannon airport that have been organising peace protests and carefully monitoring the military materials and armed soldiers that are passing through Shannon. I want to acknowledge the very important support we have had from steadfast peace activists in Galway, Cork and Dublin over the past 2 years especially. We set up a website called shannonwatch.org in which we publish key aspects of the information we compile. John Lennon will give you details on these at the next speaker. Since July 2008, we have been monitoring aircraft movements in far greater detail and we've collected a database of information. I started doing this work in 2001. That's over 8 years ago. While neutrality, and you might ask, why am I still doing it? While neutrality is an important issue, it is the human rights aspect that keeps us going here. And that is what will keep us going for many years to come. The most basic human right is the right to life. And this right has been removed from over 1 million people in Iraq, Afghanistan and Pakistan, in wars that were waged by the US, partly in revenge for 3,000 deaths on 9/11, but partly, or even mainly, as wars of resources. If these wars were stopped tomorrow, there's still an urgent need to achieve accountability for Irish complicity in these crimes against humanity. While a key aspect of what we're doing here is to inform the Irish people of what is going on at Shannon, the long-term issue of accountability is even more important. Unfortunately, many Irish people probably don't even want to know what's happening here. They prefer not to know. But clearly, it is our job to ensure that at least they are informed. The Lisbon Treaty is very important to us here in Shannonwatch because it's of the deliberate spider's web of lies that are being told to the Irish people to fool them into voting yes in this forthcoming referendum. These lies include the assertion several times a day on RTE news bulletins and other news media that Ireland is still a neutral state and that the Irish government has received legally binding guarantees that the Lisbon Treaty will in no way affect Ireland's traditional policy of neutrality. First, there are as yet no such legally binding guarantees, just a promise that at some time in the future, maybe, possibly at the next stage of EU expansion, if that ever happens, the heads of all the other 26 states will give such guarantees. All that it will take is one EU leader to say no, and guarantees won't be provided. The greatest lie, of course, is implied in this waffle about the legally binding guarantees, which implies that Ireland, Irish neutrality, does exist at this present time. You cannot legally guarantee something that does not exist. And one look across the park arc right now will show you this. There has been no neutrality in Ireland since 20th March 2003. I want to emphasise also that while we certainly want this Lisbon Treaty to be defeated next month, but win, lose or draw, the Shannon Watch team and others will not only be continuing our activities here, including monthly vigils, but we will also be stepping them up into the future. We owe this at least as an act of atonement to the many victims of the wars that have been facilitated by Ireland and our government and us by the default at Shannon Airport. But also we owe it as part of our effort to achieve some accountability from our politicians who have been and are still complicit in crimes against humanity. We want to emphasise especially the difference between, on the one hand, the large and growing volume of facts that we have produced on these abuses of Irish neutrality, and on the other hand, the speculation on the specifics of what had been going to Shannon Airport. We know, for instance, that over 1,000 CIA-related flights had been refueled at Shannon, but we had not yet confirmed the names of any specific prisoners who may have been brought to Shannon Airport, to Guantanamo and elsewhere. We also know that a large number of military and civilian chartered cargo aircraft have been refueled at Shannon, but we don't know what cargoes are on these planes. John Lennon will now give you the specifics of what we know has passed to and over Irish airspace. But we emphasise this is only part of the story. This is what we have seen and recorded electronically, but we are aware that it is most likely that other military war materials and personnel are going through subversively or more secretly. In many ways, we are surprised at how much we have been able to find out. When all put together, it amounts to clear Irish government active complicity in crimes against humanity, including torture. Finally, I want to assure you that I have no intention of falling on my kamikaze sword, Japanese style. Someone once asked the question, why did kamikaze pilots wear helmets? Surely they didn't need them where they were going. The same applies to the bogus legally binding guarantees that our government claimed to have received from the EU heads of state. These guarantees, even if they were real, cannot protect our non-existent Ireland's solutional policy of military neutrality. Thank you very much, and thank you for the big effort you've made to come here. Now, we'll sheathe our sword and go for the peaceful solution. Thank you.